broke off.
Yeah.
You can see here they're not bothered about noise of barrels being knocked over or the ribbons hanging down. You know, you never know what you're going to encounter in a driving trials obstacle. So we're not too far away from home at the moment.
Sitting behind them has got to be able to drive. Now people say, well, I've been driving for years. Well, that don't make you a driver. It's not how long you've been driving, it's whether you're a good driver. You got people drive a car, no good at it, been doing it years, they might have a license, but don't make them any good at driving. They can drive recklessly, stupidly, badly, you know. Would you go and buy a pair of horses like this for someone who's never driven a pair before? I don't know. I wouldn't have done that personally, but you know, that's how we've got it their own. So this is what we've had to work with. This is how we've got them. Going up here, double-decker buses, brake lorries, everything like that, around the arena, doing the speed, through the water, doing all that in that period of time. But what I cannot alter about these horses, and it's got to be understood, that I cannot alter, come round baby, their, you can't alter their character, their sharpness, as I refer to it. And people have said to me, I had someone say to me the other day, what you want to do is put a heavier bit in his mouth. That's the last thing I want to do. Why would I want to do that? If I can control him with a rubber bit, it's better that he gets used to and slows up and gets used to be driven in that and doing as he's told. So when I say to him, steady, come back, babies. You can hear him slowing, steady, come back. Yeah? And settle down to her pace, right? Far, far better than putting a load of iron in his mouth.
When these ponies came to us, well, when they first arrived with their owner, apparently they were transported loose in a livestock trailer. When we went to pick them up, they wouldn't tie up in a trailer, so again we had to transport them loose. So now what we're showing is that they're going, the owner's got a lorry, so we're showing that they're going into the lorry quite happily, walking up and down the ramp, standing quietly while they're tied up. Now we've got Zila on first, and Zoo's on the back. Again, we're going to tie them up, shut the partitions up, and close the ramp. Now, because these ponies never loaded, and well, they never travelled in a trailer or a lorry with partitions before, so I've been asked to do this as part of their training, just to make sure they'll load and travel, you know, safely while they're on a lorry or a trailer.
Yeah, definitely, I believe that. It's queer, isn't it? You go and talk to someone else, you can't talk to somebody else.